Chapter 17. She was still searching when Mike left. She didn't stop until my father came home. As he closed the door behind him, she mouthed silently to me, "Don't tell." "There's a rodent loose in the house," I told him. "Might even be a rat." Abby threw her ugliest face at me. "It's a mouse." My father frowned. "Just what I need. You saw it?" "Yeah, in the kitchen. Ran in here somewhere." He looked around as if he thought it was going to come out and take a bow. Abby ran up the stairs. He let out a long breath. "Well, tell your mother to get a trap." "Better get more than one," I said. He nodded. The front door opened. My mother was home. She heard my father say, "We have a mouse." She sagged, just like he had when I told him. I noticed that sag a lot. It almost always happens when they come home from work. I'll say something, or Abby will, and they sag. It's a total major sag. Cheeks, shoulders, even voice, except the eyeballs, they roll upward. It's like they've just barely been making it through the day, and they finally get home, and one little word from us. Sometimes it's just a question like, "Do you know where my Frisbee is?" And bam, they're crushed. Sag City. Sometimes I wish we could turn the day upside down so that their main time at home would be in the morning, before they get all worn out. I'll tell you, at the end of a day, it doesn't take much to crush a parent. My mother sighed.
"Get a trap."
"Me?"
said my father.
"You're the male. You're supposed to be the hunter."
She sagged toward the kitchen. She stopped. She pointed down at my football laundry bag.
"No."
"No what?" I said. She was still looking and pointing down.
"You know what. All last year you kept leaving that smelly thing here. It's not gonna happen this year, not even once. Pick it up, get it out of here."
I guess I didn't move fast enough.
"Now!"
"All right." I snatched it up.
"Thank you,"
she said, and dragged herself off. I followed my dad into his office. It's a little room in the back. Sometimes he goes right on working there half the night. "Remember that kid Schultz," I said, "I told you about? Said he was gonna bust me?" He took stuff from his briefcase.
"Did he?"
I sneered. "Huh, we had a fight before practice even started. They had to pull us apart."
"And?"
"And I got him good later. We ran some drills, and twice I plowed him into the ground. I was awesome." He looked up. He laughed. He reached out and mussed my hair.
"That's my crash."
I kind of felt like sticking around, but I figured I better not press my luck. I backed on out. "Can't wait for that first game," I said. "October 8th.
"Go get him, Crasher," he said.
He was rooting in his desk. I lugged my football bag upstairs. Our upper hallway is different from most people's. It's like an art gallery. My mother used to be a painter. Some of her paintings are hanging on the walls between the bedrooms. One of the paintings is me. You'd never know it because I was less than a year old when she did it. I'm lying on my stomach with a diaper on, looking up with this toothless grin, probably already thinking what I'm going to do when I get my first football helmet. It's a stupid picture, actually. Something like that should be kept private. Everybody who sees it laughs. I usually don't even look at it. This time I did. On the glass that covered it, some mysterious unknown person had crayoned a mustache right above my toothless grin. I put spit on my finger and rubbed it off.